Good morning, folks. We're going to start off with some tornado footage out of Monterrey, Mexico. We had some mass animal deaths yesterday in Peru. The scene of dolphins washed ashore is horrendous. There's brown tide that is threatening some fish in Texas, and kind of an odd tale here, McDonald's customers may have gotten hepatitis A from their visit. In Alaska, the Cleveland volcano had a few harmonic tremors yesterday, and across the ocean in the Philippines, they've had some severe weather and some flash flooding. I get a lot of solar tornado questions. I have no idea why these are news. They really aren't dangerous, and I've probably seen about 25 or 30 of them just in the last year. Cassini is always getting great shots around the moons of Kronos. That's Saturn for those of you not up on mythology. Bit of bad news, Bashar al-Assad still won't budge from his foreign terror stance. He's quite the stubborn mule. Good news for Australia, Indonesia, and the rest of the countries in North Korea's line of fire. Japan's got your back if need be. If you're interested in the latest Russian military satellite, we got some specs for you right here. The induction magnetometer is quiet with a few minor PC1 pulsations, which could be indicative of magnetospheric repair. We have the return of the most dangerous sunspot of the year, and while the physical view is nothing compared to her initial emergence, she is magnetically complex and does pose a significant threat. The first link below will show you why if you don't already know. We also had a filament eruption and hider flare on the north central part of the disk and a minor eruption on the west. The solar watch is in effect, folks. Be safe.